Good morning, Mike.
Which number is after?
You want to do a quick interview?
Sure.
Let's face them that way. Gonna do a quick view from the choir. Here's what the choir sees. All right. Pretty much big time. I got four people watching.
All this new technology now. I'm afraid I can't even pick the nose in public.
I'm trending over here. Four people. So.
Trending.
I'm what they call a church influencer.
Hey, you're live.
Yeah.
Did you get my email?
So if I turn around here and we watch a few there, will it just kind of
Nope, that wasn't the sound there. You can see it.
Go on forever and ever and ever.
Infinite loop?
Yes.
All right. And we're back. Who's that? Mike, don't forget to make a big lunch.
Going on now. A few years ago, before COVID hit, we had one of the lease at about the same price. When we made sure there was a lot of people who signed up. So far, no one has yet, Carl?
No,
not that we know of. So let us know on that. It's supposed to be very, very good. Also, yeah, reservations are due next week, so please let us know that if you are going to this, they put on a wonderful, wonderful show that they have in the past. So please let us know, and all the information's here. Give Carla or Tammy a call, and we'll set her up for you. Okay. Also, just to let you know a little bit too, is a number of people have bought in toner. The big ones that are in, when we come in, we can take the little bitty toners, the little ink cartridges, and turn them in, but the big toners, they will not take. And so we appreciate those that have brought them in the past, but the big, large toners are about this big. Please, we don't take them anymore.
I just wanted to remind the Wednesday night families next week is family day. So that's when our older kids and sometimes our children's church kids kind of take ownership over the worship service and do some readings, do the offering, the greeting, the ushering, all of that. So we're asking the Wednesday kids to come a little early next week on November 20th to be a part of our service and get back to our church. So hopefully we'll see that.
Morning.
Morning.
Thank you very, very much for all the wonderful boxes that we received back there. The children will be so blessed. We did, however, have 100 boxes go out, and we didn't quite get 100 back. So if you still have a box at home that you just keep on forgetting or haven't had the chance to drop it off, please feel free to do so today or tomorrow morning. But after that, we will be taking the boxes to their final home so they can be shipped out to the kids. Thank you.
We've had a couple of stars within our church. Mason Joseph played an incredible play at the high school here. He did a great job, and I really was proud of him. He did fantastic. Also, we have another star, Michelle Yardley's daughter, Ireland, is doing the play at Mauston at 3 o'clock today, Mauston High School. And so if you haven't been to it, it is great. Beardix, I heard it was really good. Is that right? You guys went? That is great. Michelle, did you ever go yet? Yeah, never mind. So there's a lot on our plate, but the Lord is coming. This is a time of Thanksgiving. And one of the things we forget, we remember Thanksgiving to eat. I love Thanksgiving. I love good turkey. In fact, I love turkey and ham. But one of the things that we forget is Thanksgiving, giving thanks to our Lord for all the blessings that we have received in this country, in the blessings anywhere in the world that God has given us. So just remember this Thanksgiving, and it's coming close, and we should do this every day, is give thanks for all that He gives us each and every day, not just from the food that we eat, but we're the blessings of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, that our Father has given to us. So as we begin today, let us give thanks, and let us give praise. Let us take just a few minutes. come on up. We've got a couple here today.
Come on down here. Right down here, guys.
Come on down. Hallway. Go, Jen, go. You know what? It's good to see you guys. What's your favorite thing on Thanksgiving? Talk to me. Pardon?
Eating cookies.
Turkey.
Turkey. Yeah, I'm sorry, there's two things in front there are gone. Little called teeth. What else do you like on Thanksgiving? Xander, what do you like the most? Eating turkey. Eating more turkey. Going somewhere with family and friends and so forth. Well, you know what? When we go out, sometimes our parents, when we go somewhere or go out for Thanksgiving, what do our parents make us do? They make us dress up really nice looking. You know? We call that appearances, to make us look good. Okay? But you guys know you and I really look good all the time, right? It's called appearances. But what God wants us to do is show our appearance through love. He wants to show us how we can love one another. And when people know that we love one another, He looks at you and I, and He can tell that Jesus is in each and every one of us when we show how much we love Jesus, right? We give a smile back. Give a smile back. When we give a Thanksgiving. So let us start giving thanks now. Let's not wait for Thanksgiving, but let us be nice to one another, okay? It's appearances, but it's really love, okay? Let's pray. Father, we just thank you for all that you give us, and let our appearances reflect you in us so that others might come to know Jesus Christ. Amen. All right, thanks, guys.
Thank you.
sing verse 3?
Sure.
Of that, Cindy? Should we do verse 3? One of the things I love about the song, it's one of my favorites, so many are. But one of the things is, when I fall down, you pick me up. When I am dry, you fill my cup. When we feel like we have nothing, He's there for us. He fills our lives. He gives us strength. And He is our all in all. Let's together read the prayer. Ever present God,
we come to you, O Lord, as an unfaithful people. We have sinned against you and done much that is wrong in your sight. The shadows of sin separate us from the light and knowledge of your presence. Loving God, in Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Cleanse us of all evil. Fill us with a new Christ Spirit. Amen.
Fill us with a new and right spirit. Change our attitudes, basically. Fill our cups. Let's come to God this morning and ask Him to forgive us all of our sins. Let us pray. Father, you have done so much for us in our lives. But Father, so often we do not appreciate what is in front of us. Father, thank you for being there for us. We ask you to send the Holy Spirit to also strengthen us. But Father, thank you for forgiving our sins this day and every day. In Jesus Christ, our sins are forgiven.
Thank you.
chapter 20, verses 45 to 47, and in the beginning of chapter 21:1-4. Listen and hear the word of God. Father, as we come before you today, let us come to you with an open heart and an open soul. So, Father, so often we try to put on appearances, and all you want of us is to speak the truth. Come to God in his glory. From the Gospel of Luke, beginning with chapter 20, verse 41. Then Jesus said to them, or 45, I should say, I'm sorry. I was doing all notes, I've got things all written on my Bible here. In hearing all the people, Jesus said to the disciples, beware of scribes who like to walk around in long robes and to love and to be greeted with respect in the marketplace, and to have the best seats in the synagogue and places of honor at the banquets. Then they devour widows' houses and for the sake of appearance say long prayers. They will receive their greater condemnation. Then Jesus looked up and he saw rich people putting their gifts into the treasury. And he also saw a poor widow with two small copper coins. Jesus said, truly I tell you, this poor widow has put in more than all of them, for all of them have contributed out of their abundance. But she, out of her poverty, has put in all that she had to live on. So ends reading of God's gracious and holy name. I think this might speak to so many of us. So many pastors, elders, any of us. You say, yeah, I go to church every single Sunday. I'm there. Why aren't you there? Well, I kind of like that, in a way. But why are you doing it? Are you doing it to approach people and draw them close to Christ? Because you were close to Christ? It talks about how there were scribes who walked around in long black robes just to make appearances, especially out and away from people. He's talking about them showing off, always wanting the best places because they are the most important people there are. Do anybody like that? Hopefully I'm not like that. But so many people try to put on airs. They try to put on appearances. They try to show off. But what are we really like with Jesus Christ in our lives? Are we willing to go out of our way to do things and bring others to Christ? What are we doing? So many of them don't even do that. Well, I pray every Sunday. I don't have to come to church. Yeah, you do. It's called coming together, reflecting one another, talking to one another, showing one another. It is also about appearances. It's about hearing more things about the Word of God. It's about not listening to things we want to hear, but the things that God wants us to hear. About love and caring for one another. It's not about appearances, and it is about appearances. We want people to know that we have the love of Jesus Christ in us, but we have to show that honestly share with others. The more you get excited about telling people about Jesus Christ, what he can do in your life. Yes, it is about appearances. No, it's not about appearances. If you're doing it for the wrong reason, then you're wrong. If you're doing it for the right reason, wanting to hear more about Christ, willing to hear more about yourself inside with Jesus Christ in your heart, that's what's important. Appearances are important, and appearances are wrong. What do we do in our lives about Christ? The poor widow. There were rich people that came, and they were contributing to the coffers, to run synagogues. Yeah, they appreciated that. But what were they doing? Were they giving it just for show? Just for appearances? Or were they giving it out of their heart? The poor widow who came and had two copper coins, literally probably about 2 cents. She gave everything she had. But what that meant was, it's not the two copper coins. She gave everything she had to God. That's what we should do. We shouldn't, you know, have to necessarily go out and spend every dime we have, unless it's a Christmas gift for Pastor Steve. But you reach out and you give from your heart. That's what it's talking about. It's talking about giving of yourself so that others might give. It's about not the money. It's about giving of yourself and who you are. If you're giving God leftovers, forget it. He already gave you everything you have. We forget about that. He's given us everything we have, and we should be thankful and show him how much we give. Not just necessarily in finances, but also in our hearts. That's what he wants us to give. He wants us to give love to one another. Is it about appearances? Yes and no. How do you give? Do you give out of your leftovers? Or do you give God from your heart, which is Jesus Christ, who gave you everything through his crucifixion on the cross, so that we might be forgiven? So yeah, go out there and give. Give of yourself. Give of everything we have, because God is giving you everything. Amen. Let us stand and turn to the hymnal to 429. They'll know me when we are Christians by our what?
Love.
And we pray that all unity may one day be restored. And
Pastor Dory. Let us pray. Father, we come to you today. We will give you thanks. Oh, Father, we also need your intercession. We need that assurance. But Father, we know that when we give all that we have to you, to your people, to share with one another and to care for one another. But Father, there are times that we need your reassurance. And so often we forget to look around. And we forget that we are so blessed. And Father, we come to you today in prayer. We ask you to guide us and lead us. But Father, we also remember others in our prayer so that they might put the healing touch of God in their hearts and in their bodies, but also your comforting arms around them. Let us pray in silence. Father, you hear our prayers. And Father, we ask for special prayers on Eric Backus' mom. Father, put your healing hand upon her and your touching arms around her. We ask you to be with Donna Smith's daughter, Carrie. Give her the assurance that she needs. Continue to be with Lisa Bates' brother, Roy. We ask you, Father, just to be with Mike Thompson today. And just give him the strength and put your healing hand upon him. And Father, we ask you to continue to be with Bob Danner. And Father, just continue to be giving the strength that he needs. And he is so thankful, Father, for all that is given to him. And continue to be with Corky Shumway. Father, we thank you so much for her recovery. You continue to put your healing hand upon Mike Noble and his family, Father. But Father, we reach out to you today. We want you to hear our prayers and our thanksgivings. As we pray,
our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Father, the poor widow gave all she had, but what she really truly gave was her heart. Let us give back to God the blessings that he has given to us.
Take a five.
But Father, accept these gifts so that we might do your work and your will. In your gracious and holy name, Father, amen. Well, if you turn in your hymnals to 425, it was a great song. Bind us together.
Love.
We called him the bug guy. He sprayed our church and dance for years and years, and we really appreciate all that you give. Not only that, is your family, Norm. We thank you for everything you've done for this community that people will never know how much you've given back. And we appreciate that. So all I can say is,
happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you.
Thank you.
Especially 19. Any other announcements? We have food and fellowship after church here today, but remember, it's appearances. But let people see Jesus Christ and his love that's in you. Share that and give that to others. May our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and may the Father in heaven be with each and every one of you, now and forevermore. And what do we say?
Amen.
Amen.
Lord, let's go home.